Amen, amen, amen. If you remain standing for our scripture reading, amen, amen, amen. And our scripture reading will be coming from a very familiar passage of scripture. Amen. The 100th division of Psalms. And it says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Oh, y'all heard it. She said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. I know it's cold outside, but come on, stand back up on your feet. Come on, let's get warm for Jesus. Hallelujah. She said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Come on, put your hands together like this. We come to lift our hands and give Him praise. Now, you know, we come to lift our hands. Come on. We come. bless the name of the Lord in this place. If he's been good to you, he's been kind to you, you ought to have a ridiculous praise on your lips. Tell the Lord, thank you. I've made it this far to the end of the year. He's kept me. He's protected me. So I got to tell the Lord, thank you. I'm here today to tell you that he is the risen King. He's seated in majesty. Hallelujah. Do I got any true worshipers in the house? True worship. True worship. Because we know who he is. We know whose we are. Hallelujah. Y'all gonna sing with me? Listen.
Hallelujah.
You See, the Spirit of God is moved by a sound. So when he tells you to open up your mouth and declare what he is, anything you need, anything you're asking for, my God hears you through your sound. So I want you to just open up your mouth and declare right now in the name of Jesus, whatever it is you need, whether it's healing, whether it's a sound mind, whether it's food on your table, whether it's just you just loving God with whole heart. So just ask right now for God to give you a clean heart, renewing you the right spirit. Hallelujah. No more will you walk out of here with lack. Amen. Hallelujah. Everything you need is taken care of. In the name of Jesus, we praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. In this place. Somebody give God some praise in this place. The Spirit is heavy here today. Somebody give God some praise in this place. I didn't come in here every Sunday to give you a chill in the suit. See, I got something to be thankful for. Hallelujah. I was able to walk in here with my legs this morning. Be thankful for somebody to wake up this morning. next to. You could be sitting next to a miracle right now. When I look around in this building and see all the blessings and all the miracles that God is doing here, you ought to just get happy. Just like I told the Sunday school class this morning, in a few more days we might be celebrating Christmas. You might not get what you want. But if you wake up, that ought to be a gift for God. Because he didn't have to wake us up. He could have snatched some of us a long time ago in our mess. But he let us a little while longer. Amen. Come on, bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. He is worthy to be praised. Mr. Brooks is going to come with our announcements.
This morning, our first announcement is that on New Year's Eve, we will have service here from 7 p.m. until 9 p.m. Before service, we will serve food. The church will be providing all of the meat. We need you to bring your sides, drinks, and desserts, but the church will be providing all of the meat. On Christmas morning, we will not have breakfast after Christmas. We are just going to have service from 8 a.m. until 10 a.m. So we will have service from 8 until 10 a.m. on next Sunday. After service, there will be desserts and drinks free for you to take over in the fellowship hall. So when you leave service, you feel free to go over there and take those items until they're gone. Those of you who have not placed your name in the hat for the card that they're giving away, you can do that today or next Sunday. And you give your name to Sister Carla. Questions have been asked, what type of car you're being blessed? It's a free car, so that doesn't matter. Just receive your blessing. So if you would like to put your name in the hat, do so by seeing Sister Carla. We will be having community service January the 14th from 9 to 12 at Feed the Children. Those that have questions or want to sign up, please see Minister out. The ushers and the mothers would like to send their thanks to their families and friends and auxiliary that came out and ate Christmas dinner with them on yesterday. Our matriarchs and our doorkeepers of the church, we thank them for all that they do for St. Louis, and thank y'all for coming out and supporting them on last night. And last but not least, I have to do what the Lord tells me to do, because sometimes I'm not obedient to my parents and that gives me a consequence. So that's my Heavenly Father, so I have to do what He tells me to do. And one of the things that Rachel spoke about was some people are not here or could not be here or shouldn't be here. And yesterday I was given a testimony by a young lady that really touched me and it wrestled with me. And if you see her, you would never know that she's struggling with cervical cancer, which has now moved to her lungs, and she has chemo, but yet she still is a mother and takes care of her children, and she gets up and she's motivated and she does what she has to do. And I know what that does by watching what my mother went through. So sometimes she has negative people around her that pours into her spirit. So we are a church and we are a praying church, and I just want her to come up here so that, and those of you who are cancer survivors, come up here so that either Pastor Nick or Sweetie can pray with this young lady. But this is fun, and y'all don't know what she's been going through, but yet she's pushing every day. She gonna go every day, and you don't know that she's struggling what she's going through because she has to, and she believes in a living and alive God, a walking and a talking God. She knows that He's a healer. She knows that He can and He will. So despite what the doctors are saying, she knows that God can turn things around in the midnight hour. So I want all of y'all who have positive energy to spread your positive love around her and give her encouragement and let her know that God can and God will. Amen.
Jesus, right now, God, we ask that you would touch her right now. God, continue to give her strength right now. God, we plead the blood over her right now in the name of Jesus.
Jesus. God, right now, we ask that you just have your way. God, we say thank you right now. God, we don't want to believe what the doctors, but we believe your report, God. Right now, we ask you to continue to give her strength, God, to take care of her children, God. That God continues to let her be alive because, God, you have a purpose for her. You have some more work for her to do, God. And in the name of Jesus, right now, we say have your way in her life, God, right now. Touch right now in the name of Jesus. God, right now, whatever that she needs, God, don't let her lack for nothing, God. Let her have more than enough. That God, that she'll be able to open up the windows of heaven and you can just pour out blessings upon her. God, thank right now in the name of Jesus. And we claim the victory right now. If you believe that God is a healer right now, clap your hands. Clap your hands, all ye people. Clap your hands as you go clap them all. In the name of Jesus. And it is so. Come on, come on. If you really believe, keep praying. If you really believe, keep praying. Yeah, well, you got to take your hands off of her. You got to take your hands off of her right now. time survivor of cancer. From the beginning for her, she said she knows she'll do it for. Yeah. Let me tell you, let me say this to Angelica. Don't never apologize for what the Holy Spirit tells you to do. Because if the Holy Spirit told you to do that, if you hadn't done it, then he'd have got you for not doing what he told you to do. Sometimes God got to interrupt the program. We can't go by protocol. He got to interrupt things. And he just come when he wants to. And you just got to move when the Lord said move.
Thank you.
apologize for the Holy Ghost. Amen. Yeah. Yeah. We don't apologize and we don't put a time limit on it. Amen. Amen. Because we came here to give God praise. Because He is worthy to be praised. Amen. Yeah, he's good. He is so good. And it takes a filthy rag like us. And just keeps on blessing us over and over and over again. Amen. He died. What a mighty God we serve. Yeah. Yes. Amen. This time we're going to have our praise dancer, Sister Janelle, who's going to come and they're going to minister to us. Amen.
Well, now it is offering time. Yeah, it is offering time.
I believe.
I believe. That's what he said. Here in St. Luke, we have three ways of giving our offering here. We also have the app Giveify and Sister Franklin. She's here. Okay. She's coming and will be in the back of the vestibule with the credit card. Amen. Amen. Sister Franklin. Good morning, Sister Franklin. Good morning. Good morning. Amen. Amen. She's going to be there back to take that. Amen. Sister Keisha is here for, you would like to give to a needy family for Christmas. She's taking up for that. Last day's today. Sister Carla here, if you want to put your name, just give it to Minister House for the car. Amen. 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 We, if you need an offering envelope, raise your hands or she will bring it to you, Precious Wheel. Amen. We are now under the direction of our usher, Mr. Michael William. Anthony, we are yours.
Y'all, I wouldn't rather be in nobody's hands but God. Amen. Amen. My daddy couldn't do what God can do. My mama can't do what God can do. I don't know about God. I'd rather be in God's hand. It's a blessing and a privilege to be in the house of God one more time. Amen. I don't know about y'all, but people have lost their lives. I don't know if y'all heard about the young man that jumped off a bridge and died. And one of my preaching friends was there, actually was walking on the bridge, saw the man, and when he yelled to the man had already jumped off. And said when the man realized he jumped, he started trying to. Amen. Amen. But it didn't work out right. And so I want y'all to kind of close this in your mind. It could be you. This side got it. This side, it could be you. Amen. Realizing that we thank God for keeping us in His hand. Amen. I don't know about y'all, but these last 2 weeks have been very detrimental to me. Family issues, financial issues, and health issues. And the devil's really been trying to get at me. Sure. Amen. I'm still in the house of prayer. Still giving God praise. Amen. Amen. Thank God for situations like this because they give you a chance to find a sermon to preach. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm glad I'm at St. Luke this morning. Say, neighbor, just matter of fact, I'm glad I'm in church this morning. Amen. 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 Luke 22. Luke 22, when you find it, please stand for the reading and reverence of God's word. We thank God for all of our leadership here at this church. Amen. See, there it is. There it is. It's contagious. It's contagious. Somebody know God's really been good. Amen. And while y'all looking at him, he's kept y'all all year long. Amen. You don't got for 6 or 7 days of this year. I wish you'd lift your hands and Lord, I thank you for keeping. That's like fire. Somebody go catch you.
sing the song.
Bless his name. Bless his name. Spirit is so high. I'm urged to read, but y'all won't let me read. Bless the name of Jesus.
Come on.
It's all right.
It's all right.
We're going to do this quick. Luke 22. Luke 22, 39. We're going to do this quick.
Take your time. Take your time.
Oh, y'all not getting me to preach. I'm going to just give y'all one verse. Y'all not preach. Go back to the 45th verse. That's all I'm going to be able to do. I'll tell you how the rest of the sermon. Get back up there. Now let him praise him. Let him praise him. Scream, shout. Let somebody hear you. Amen. The Bible said, let the redeemed of the Lord say. So what you gonna do? Somebody gotta say so. If God brought you out, you gotta say so. If God healed your body, you gotta say so. If God died on the cross for you, you gotta say so. Luke 22:45. Yeah. There it is. And when he arose up from prayer,
yeah,
and was come to his disciples, he found them sleeping for sorrow. He said to them, "Why you sleep? Arise and pray, lest ye enter into temptation." You may be seated in the presence of God. Got up from prayer.
Come on now, come on, come on.
You go see him at his disciples. So why are you sleeping? Amen. Get up and pray that you won't fall into temptation. I'm going to be very, very brief. But I want to preach from the thought, brothers and sisters. Satisfied with mediocrity.
Come on, man.
Satisfied with mediocrity.
Come on,
now. I was watching, I'm a big kid, so I was watching Kung Fu Panda. Bless your heart. Don't talk about me, Lord, watching you. I was watching Kung Fu Panda 3, and the big fat panda was in agony and pain that he could not find out how to do a certain move.
All right, come on.
To save his people.
Uh-huh.
And his master went over and told him these things. He said, if you only do what you can do, you never be able to do what you're capable of doing. I think that is the sentiment and the move I want to make for our text today.
All right.
Brothers and sisters, if we only search for what we want, we'll never get to the amount of things God needs us to have. And if we only walk in the path that's pleasing to us, we'll never go where God has destined for us to go. And brothers and sisters, I think this is the perfect time to suggest to you that if you're only searching for limited amounts of pain, but searching for longevity in your prosperity, you'll never get what God has for you. It's time of Christmas, brothers and sisters, where cultural diffusion has now changed the look of Calvary and salvation and the birth of Christ. We now search for Santa on a red sled and a red-nosed reindeer to lead the group and to literally go to over a billion homes and deliver gifts that people have been making on the list for 365 days. We've been to a Christmas tree with pretty little lights and ornaments, and we're supposed to make our blessings surrounded by this particular tree and a jolly fat white man named St. Nick. I'm going to tell you, you won't find happiness. happiness in that. That there is a real Christmas story that involves bloodshed like these red armies. That there's a Christmas story that involves the sun refusing to shine in midday. It is a Christmas story about a man oozing with water out of his skin as he begins to lift himself up by his heel on a rugged cross with nails stuck in his hand. Just talking about Jesus. Amen. I don't know. Let me tell you, Pop, he died for me. I know he died for me. The stuff I couldn't do, he did for me. I wonder, is there anybody here to look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I know he died for me. I know he died for me. I know he took the nail for me. I know he took the nail for his feet for me. Good Christmas story. See that? Good Christmas story, brothers and sisters. Cultural diffusion has taken the Christ out of Christmas. And they replace it with an X. Even jobs in the Alpha Mills Bar where I employed it. They say in holidays, you don't say Merry Christmas.
Yeah, come on.
If you have to say Merry Christmas, you don't say Merry Christmas, but say Merry Xmas. And if you don't want to say that, you should say, Happy Holidays. Yes. Brothers and sisters, I think we need to go back in time. And discover these things, because even a wise man told me, when you don't read your history, you'll do nothing but repeat what everybody else has done. If you search in history, brothers and sisters, the thought of Calvary, y'all stick with me.
Come on.
Calvary and the art of crucifixion. It is a capital punishment, deacons, that the Romans did not create. The Bible will tell you in timeline that the Persians Empire created this thing called crucifixion by the way of the letter X. And the letter X, brothers and sisters, when you nail it, it stretches so much so that it caused a short and sweet death. Causing the individual or persons of capital punishment to go ahead and die. The Greeks went and took over the Persians. And when they took over the Persians, they didn't adopt this particular exercise of capital punishment. The Greeks been taken over by the Roman Empire. And they picked up this harsh and embarrassing capital punishment and turned that X into the letter T. And the T is designed, brothers and sisters, to allow you to suffer longer and much harder. People who have got on this particular T have stayed on there for days and days suffering at the hands of these names. And when you look at it, it suggests, brothers and sisters, when you take us back to the X, you're only telling us that we're having a short and sweet and temporary pain that will never give us longevity and salvation. And when we look at the cross, when we look at this T, it gave Jesus a long suffering death that caused us to be having life and life eternal. And I want to suggest to you, brothers and sisters, when you search for little things, when you search for little pain, you will never get longevity in your prosperity. Don't try to run from pain. Send a text, brothers and sisters. If you only knew what you can do, you'd never be able to do. You'd never be able to do what you're capable of doing. And Jesus shows us. Luke 22 and 39. He's in the Garden of Gethsemane by the ways of Mount Olives. He's in there and he tells his disciples before he goes, the Bible says, a stone throw away. He says, pray that you will not fall into temptation. Lord have mercy. Y'all didn't catch it. Then when Jesus goes and prays, he prays, say, Lord, if you will, take this cup, take this pain from me. But God, it's your will, let it be done. And the Bible says that the angel came and strengthened Jesus Christ. And then after strengthening Jesus, I feel like preaching this thing here. After strengthening Jesus Christ, chopping on the ground. And then they said he got up and went to his disciples and they were sleeping. Brothers and sisters, I want to go ahead and be the human side of this text. That actually we do cry. Amen. Now, problems do make you fatigued. Problems do make you want to go to sleep. Problems do make you want to cry your eyes out. But I want to suggest to you that if you're going to have a merry little Christmas and a happy new year, you got to get your butt up and pray this thing through. You got to get your butt up and put work on your knees. You got to get your butt up and close your hands and Father, if it's possible, take this thing from me that I may not have to go for. Sometimes, brothers and sisters, you got to work on your knees. Says, you gotta get up and pray. Let's discover a couple of things about the particulars to a Merry Christmas.
All right.
Not being so satisfied with mediocrity. Yeah. Brothers and sisters, we'll notice the position of Christ.
All right.
Position of Christ not being satisfied with mediocrity. Look what he decides to do.
What is it?
He decides to pray.
All right.
Notice, brothers and sisters, in the Gospels of Jesus Christ, Calvary has been a prophecy for Jesus. That is his persistent will of God. Imagine every day you wake up, your persistent will is die for no good Negro. Sister Sue, Brother Bill,
all right.
You gotta die for Sister Sue,
yeah.
And Brother Bill. And this is the first time we've seen Jesus be personable and inhumane reactions to every time he's waking up. Brother Sue, for Brother Bill, Sister Sue,
all right.
Dying for them. And this is what Jesus decides to do out of all the pain he's going through. He decides to pray. Look what Jesus does. Not only does he decide to pray, but he tells people that are with him, you ought to pray too. Y'all ain't got a chair, brothers and sisters. And I want to help you right now as your family begins to go through this season and you go into the next year. You need to master the art of positioning yourself in prayer. Because everything may not go the way you want to, and everybody may not love you, and every dream you have may not come true, but prayer is an art of stability around all instability. Prayer can hold you when nobody wants to hold you. Prayer can keep peace in your mind where everything's a toxic term. You need to heart to pray. Jesus is positioning prayer. I told you I'm going to be quick, but then it is not only the position, but the place for the particulars of a Merry Christmas. The Bible says he's in the Mount of Olives, which is what we know as Bread of the Gethsemane, the Garden of Gethsemane. And he's down there and he's praying. The interesting thing I love about this garden, brothers and sisters, that it produced olives, which is a fruit.
Yes,
sir.
Right.
Well,
yeah.
It's an olive. Olives that are being produced on the tree, but not only this that I like about it, brothers and sisters, but the olives have to be gone through Gethsemane to get pressed. Y'all ain't hearing me yet. Brothers and sisters, so the olives are on the tree, they get ripe, they fall down, they go in a bucket, they send them through Gethsemane, so the men could press stones on them by the bare feet of them and step on them all day. And the problem with oil is oil runs out fast when you get it in the bottle, but it comes out slow when you get it out of its fruit. And so the men, day in and day out, are pressing, and the oil sometimes would come out, and then it wouldn't come out. Sometimes they would get unripe. Olives, and they wouldn't come out. They just kept on pressing and pressing till their feet began to bruise. They kept on pressing and pressing, and they kept on pressing, and they kept on pressing. But y'all ain't got to check. They kept on pressing. They kept praise then. Interesting enough, Jesus is getting pressed.
Yes.
First thing he does is pray.
All right.
Praising his problem.
Uh-huh.
And praying in a place that produces a prince.
Yes, sir.
I think we all, brothers and sisters, to get out of us so we can be capable of doing things we never done.
Yes,
we need a prince.
Yes.
And watch what the Bible says. It's called pressing. He's praying.
Uh-huh.
Listen already. The Bible suggests that what causes the pressing was the prayer. That literally is not an easy process to pray. But it causes a pressing on the inside of you to get what's on the inside of you on the outside of you so you can be able to handle the context of what's around you. Y'all ain't kind of checked. That's why we use the oil. That's why we anoint people, because it was the pressing of men and women who pressed on their feet, and we use it to anoint your hand because it was somebody's hurt and pain that brought it through. Use what was on the inside of him to handle the context of where he was. That when you look around and nobody's ever there, when you look around and there are no options, the text says praying produces what you need to handle where you are. Oh, y'all ain't getting it here. This side sweet. The Bible says that the pressing produces what you need on the inside of you to handle where you are. Y'all ain't got it yet. Cry, y'all help me out. The Bible says that what you need is on the inside of you, and where you are causes the pressing for what you need. Position of Christ. Place,
come on, God.
But the people.
You already have. Yes, sir. Yes.
People,
yes, sir.
Are you?
Yes.
Luke, he don't say what to say.
All right.
He just tells them to get up.
Yes.
But the Bible doesn't make a specific sound to who they're talking to.
That's right.
You implement yourself.
That's right. That's right.
Who's sleeping?
That's right.
You.
Yeah.
Who needs to get up and pray?
You.
You do. The new international version says they were sleeping for their affliction or their sorrow.
Right.
But the King James version says they were sleeping from sorrow. Now, when I sleep from sorrow, that means something has happened to me. That's caused me to be fatigued. And I can't handle my bodily function. When I'm sleeping for sorrow, that means I'm in the present time of suffering. And I'm sleeping while I'm suffering. Now, brothers and sisters, now when we're looking at this text, Jesus clearly told them before he left.
All right.
He told them, listen. Pray that you won't fall into temptation. They bugged out there sleeping and troubled. Now, I want to go ahead and get this. There's no big theology behind it. It's very simple, brothers and sisters.
Come on, help us.
That is very humane of you to sleep when you have an outlet to take from your problem. You are literally being self-satisfied and selfish when Jesus offers an outlet for you to take and you don't want to take it. And like I said in the beginning of the text, when you look for temporary pain, limited pain, you won't get longevity in your blessing. But I want to know, is there anybody here that said, God, I'll suffer on your behalf only to get what I got up in glory. I'll suffer a little while to get what I got to get. I'll suffer a little was fighting a cold. It was so bad I couldn't breathe. I felt pressure in my face. I was praying to God. I said, God, I cannot focus. I'm a political science major, so I don't do bubble in questions. A, B, C, and D. I write paragraphs and paragraphs and papers for finals. I said, God, I cannot write and I cannot do this work with this pressure. Cannot do it. It gets so bad, brother, since I would fall asleep, waking up at 2 in the morning, and didn't do what I need to do. But since I was tired, then I had to go to work. Tired, I'm like, God, I need your help. I need you to come. If you don't come through nowhere else, this is the time. I've been paying out of pocket for tuition. I need to do what I got to do. And it seemed like, brothers and sisters, the results went bad. When I looked, I cried. I've been trying hard, and I cried. And interestingly enough, thank God for St. Luke bringing back the show.
Right. Come on, man. Come on.
The Vice President of Academic Affairs came to preach at St. Luke on Super Sunday last year.
Yes, sir.
You remember his name was Dr. Hardy.
That's right.
And I went to his office and said, Dr. Hardy, I have some issues that caused me not to be able to get in the class on time. I need help. I cannot afford to take another class on. I need you to investigate it for me. And he sent me to somebody. He didn't say he was going to do it. He just sent me to somebody.
All right.
And that somebody, by the time I got there, said they had an email that said everything taken care of. Y'all ain't got a check, brothers and sisters. I want to let y'all know, brothers and sisters, if you don't remember anything I say to you today, keep praying. Keep praying. And keep the faith. All right? Touch your neighbor. Say, neighbor, keep praying. Keep the faith, y'all ain't doing it. I want somebody to say, keep praying. Keep waiting. And keep the faith. How dare you do it? Keep praying. And keep the faith. Look to somebody and say, neighbor, keep praying. Keep waiting. And keep the faith. Everything will be all right. Y'all turn that thing around. Sooner than very soon. To have a Merry Christmas, what I gotta do? That's easy. Pray. And it may not turn out like you wanted to, but God is able to do it. Exceedingly and abundantly. And above all, you can ask some things. I dare you to turn it over to Jesus and see what he does. I'm done. One more story. I was in my house.
Yeah.
Told y'all I've been going through quite a few things.
Yeah.
In my house, Friday. I was sitting there, got up early. This adult life, you pay bills and stuff.
Right. Right.
Right.
All right.
Rent.
That's right.
Can't even think of the rest. Amen, amen. All I want for Christmas is a bill paid. Amen, amen. I'm sitting there with index cards. I had my expenses on this side.
Yeah.
And the money I had on this side.
Yeah.
And my expenses on this side. The money I had on this side. And when I tried to switch them out.
Yeah.
Go to the right. The right can go to the left. And then my bill, my money was on this side. Expenses was on that side. And I tried to do what they call mix, match them up, and I tried to draw the line, but the line couldn't go. And I got to cry. Because I don't like to call my parents, I'm a man. So I started to say, God, you know. Help me. I started to pray. I started to wait. pray. Keep on waiting. Try to keep the faith. Y'all gonna get it in the way. I kept on praying. I kept on praying. Kept the faith. Tears oozing out my eyes. Anger, pain in my head. I'm trying to pray. Kept on waiting. Keep the faith. I dare you to look back at them and say, keep on waiting. Silent, and my dad showed up. And my dad picked up the phone and said, "Hey dad, what's up?" He said, "Son, what do you need?" And I said, "Daddy, what do you mean what I need?" I said, "I don't need nothing." He said, "Son, I called you because I know you need something." He said, I said, "Daddy, what you mean?" He said, "Son, I know when you messed up, you don't call me in 2 days." He said, "Son, I made you. Son, I raised you. And I just want to tell somebody, God's gonna call you.
Yeah.
That was for us. That was for us. I'm trying to move on. But how many of you know that when you've been praying for something for a long time, and somehow, some way, not when you think it ought to happen, but God lets it happen. Somebody take this mic.
Amen. It's time for prayer. I need you to get your butt up and pray. Get your butt up and pray. The altar is open, brothers and sisters. I need you to pray. You don't have a church home to fellowship in.
Thank you, Lord.
The altar is open. You want grown Christian experience and rededicating your life, the altar is also open. If you haven't proclaimed Jesus Christ to be your Lord and Savior, the altar is definitely open for you. There's still room at the cross. I pray for you. You pray for me. Change things and watch God change me. Watch God change me. Oh, I pray for you. You pray for me. Watch God change. Ready to go into the altar prayer. Want to know if there's anyone here on the altar that's aspiring to be saved. If all you say, raise your hand. If you say, raise your hand. Amen. We bless God for that. Amen. I still thank God for those folks who got saved. Amen. Let's lift the name of Jesus. Thank God you're saved. Amen. Thank God you're saved. When he said, how many of us are saved? So with that being said, if you're saved, that means you believe in God and you believe in prayer, right? So I'm going to ask that. Pray, like the song says, pray for one another. And when you pray, folks will say, pray right good. Because you realize that we're living in some troubled times. We all realize that these are the last days. If you have read in the Bible what's going to happen in the last days, it's coming to fruition. And I tell folks all the time that I'm foolish enough to believe it from the beginning to the end. So when things happen, it don't bother me because it's in the Bible. So I'm okay with that. So I'm just going to ask that y'all pray for me and pray for one another. And I want to start this prayer with saying this, and I want you to realize what I'm saying. And That's a song that says, Father, I stretch my hand to thee. That's what I want us to do in our hearts right now. Is to stretch our hand to thee. As humble as I can, Heavenly Father. Realizing, Heavenly Father, that you're God and God alone. I'm asking right now, Heavenly Father, to teach me how to pray. What to pray for, Lord. Realizing, God, that you've been better to me than I myself. And I just want to say thank you for that, Heavenly Father. I want to pause right now, Heavenly Father, and thank you for all that you have done, all that you will do, and all that you can do, Lord. Realizing that you can do everything but fail. I think we all need to realize that sometimes. You can't fail and you cannot tell a lie. And I'm glad about that. Because it says that you'll be a shelter. We gotta believe that. It says that you're bread in a starving land. So we believe that. Says that you are water in dry places. Thank you, God. So I'm asking right now, Heavenly Father, that you draw down right now, Lord, as close as we can bow, Heavenly Father. Draw in our wondering minds, Heavenly Father. Give ease to troubling hearts, Lord. Lord, be a mind regulator right now. Even a heart fixer, Lord. I'm asking, Lord, that you bless St. Luke, Heavenly Father. Bless us in a special way, Lord. Bless us individually, Heavenly Father. Lord, I ask, Heavenly Father, that you keep love in our hearts. I ask, Lord, that you keep us in the Word, Heavenly Father. Realizing that we can't make it without it, Lord. Said in the beginning, there was the Word. The Word was with God. The Word was God, Heavenly Father. So I'm trusting and believing in your Word, Heavenly Father. So I'm just going to ask you to do what you said you're going to do, Heavenly Father. Come see about your children, Heavenly Father. Says that you lay low in Zion, Lord. So I'm looking said, not only do you just lay there, said that you are precious and elect stone, cornerstone, Heavenly Father, meaning that you can be the anchor that we need, Lord. So I'm asking, Heavenly Father, that those that ain't rooted right now, Lord, I'm asking, Lord, that you help us to dig deep, Lord, realizing that you are our anchor, Heavenly Father. And I'm asking you, Heavenly Father, help us to realize that if we hold on to your unchanging hand, will be all right, God. I'm asking, Heavenly Father, that you help us to pray for one another, Lord. I'm asking, Heavenly Father, that you just help us to love one another, Lord. Bless those, Heavenly Father, that are on a bed of affliction, Heavenly Father. Those that are going through their trials and tribulations, Heavenly Father. Realize that it'll make us stronger, Lord. I'm a witness, Heavenly Father. I know what you have done in my life, Lord. And if you can do it for a stinking wretch like me, Heavenly Father, anyone, Lord. I just can't help but to go back to the cross, Heavenly Father, and realize what you did, Heavenly Father. Ah, it said that you stood there and said, send me out of to save a dying world, Lord. Lord, realize that we die daily, Heavenly Father. So we must pray, Heavenly Father, every day, Lord. So I'm asking right now, Heavenly Father, on this day, Lord, that you hear our prayer, Heavenly Father. Answer our prayer, Heavenly Father. Lord, I ask, Heavenly Father, that you just give us what we stand in the need of. Lord, if it's more love, I ask that you pour it into us, Heavenly Father. If it's hate that we need to remove, Heavenly Father, I ask that you purge and prune us, Lord. Take us to the potter's house. Mold us in what you would have us to be, Heavenly Father. Fix us up for long time travel. Heavenly Father, that you help us to realize that we got to run on to see what the end's going to be. I'm just a foolish enough to believe, Heavenly Father, that in the end, Heavenly Father, we're going to be white as stone inside. Not worried about the outside, Heavenly Father. What's down deep inside? inside of us, Lord. This flesh can't get to heaven, Heavenly Father. All of these souls of ours, Heavenly Father. I ask, Lord, that you purge and prune us, Heavenly Father. Clean us up right now, Heavenly Father. Lord, I ask that you get us in line with your Heavenly Father. Let your will be done in our lives, Heavenly Father. Bless my children and my children's children, Heavenly Father. Bless my wife in a special way, Lord. I'm asking you right now to strengthen her where she's weak. Some of us need you to be a company keeper. Some of us need you to be a burden bearer. I need you to be my everything, Heavenly Father. Realize that I can't make it without you, Lord. So I'm asking you, Heavenly Father, to be whatever it is that you need to be in our lives, Heavenly Father. But most of all, continue to be the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Heavenly Father. I thank you right now, Heavenly Father. I claim the victory right now, Heavenly Father. Lord, whatever it is going on in their life, Lord, I'm asking you to do it, Heavenly Father. I'm asking you to do it right now, Heavenly Father. I know that you can and I know that you will, Lord. I thank you right now in advance, Heavenly Father. I said, I thank you right now in advance, Heavenly Father. I thank you right now in advance, Heavenly Father. Realizing that you can't fail, so I thank you right now, Heavenly Father. I thank you right now, Heavenly Father. I thank you right now. I ask these in your darling son Jesus. The church say amen.
Amen.
Well, hold on. We can do benediction just yet. We'll allow our Deacon Frazier to come and give us our rest, our announcement. We'll come back with our benediction. Amen.
Amen. Amen. We won't stay long. I wanted to give Big Mike and the ushers an opportunity to have a few presentations. I want to let them do that real briefly, and then I have one other small quick announcement, and we'll have a benediction.
Mothers and the deacons on behalf of Michael Floyd and the Usher's Ministry.
Amen.
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 We're obviously grateful for the Ushers and the mothers. They serve faithfully week in and week out, and I don't take it for granted anybody that serves this church. So thank you for your service and all that you do. Thank you. Next door, on behalf of the church, we have just small, it ain't nothing big, but some bags of fruit and candy canes. Obviously, let the kids go first. And those that are still, if there's still bags remaining, you're welcome to that as well. I know some people may not make it next Sunday, so we want to try to at least go ahead and get out as much as we can get out today. Amen? If I don't see you between now and next week, I hope you have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And at this point in time, we're going to ask Minister Nicholas Patterson if he'll come back up and give us our closing benediction. Amen.
Amen. Before we do that, I want y'all to be patient with us. We have someone who's from this church who wants to make a very special announcement, which is very dear to my heart, because I know how this announcement goes as a young preacher. So I do want y'all to have y'all hearts and ears open to hearing what God has brought us. Amen.
Amen.
For years, I've always been in place, but I've been out of place.
All right.
And I'm just ready to surrender to you.
Amen.
And to answer the calling that's on my life.
Amen.
I was going to do it. I passed the skin, but I was going to pray and I was going to wait for the right moment.
Amen.
And I'm feeling today is the day. Yeah. I can completely surrender.
Thank you.
St. Luke, y'all ought to be rejoicing right now. Amen. I don't know about some of y'all. Some of y'all ain't surrendered to God. But she come to surrender and serve Jesus. Amen. Your child, she may help your child get saved. She may help your family get saved. You ought to give God praise for this. Amen. We thank God for the supporters. We thank God for those who are praying. Keep praying for her. Amen. This don't mean the road ended. This means the road just began. Amen. And preachers know we ought to keep praying because this road ain't easy. Amen. We are so thankful to God for what God is going to do in the life of her ministry. I do want to pray over that. And so if you all extend your hands to her as we begin to pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we ask for nothing but your hands on this soul. We ask that you speak through her, God. Walk with her. Talk with her, God. When she get weary, God, be her joy and her strength. When she begin to cry, God, wipe all the tears from her eyes. When she don't have words to say, God, you be the words that let her say it. And God, see, teach the Calvary story, God, that souls must come to be saved. That transfigured and moving so they can go into discipleship. This we ask it all in Jesus' name. Let every heart shout amen. 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 Brothers and sisters, you may be dismissed.